Hello there, everyone, and welcome back to Napoleon Total War 3. I've done, I think, one turn it is since the last video. But I want to go ahead and do this battle first, and so we end the Austrians, so the Austrians are over, and then after the battle, or maybe during the battle, I can explain. Sorry, what has happened? We're gonna have Ney as the reinforcement army, and the attack is going to be led by Jean-André Junot. So he's gonna lead the attack with his army. Gonna have a march in there first, make sure. And at this point, we're not at war with Russia. I was able to secure peace once more. They have so many armies, and so I feel that I want to really just end some of these other forces first before I go ahead and sort of try invading the Russians. I could go ahead and outrace all this, but since it's the last one, I figure that I should go ahead and play this, and you know, this will be the last time I fight the Austrians, because they have no more, they have nowhere else to go. I mean, I've been at war with the I've fought with the Austrians the most, I think, and it's taken so long just to finish them off. But finally, the day has come that we can end the Austrians and move on to greater targets. Just looking quickly at the ground here. My cannons will be over here, and then the howitzers will be here in the center, shelling the enemy. Then we've got the line. You know what, we're gonna bring everyone with the line. And this is the army that has a lot of... We're gonna hold the cannons just to start off with. This is the army that has a lot of voltigeers and light infantry. So maybe I'll have them move up first. And then we've got the heavy cavalry. And two units of light cavalry. We'll see how the what the Austrians do. Right now, the only thing we can see is the Archduke. Ah, yes, because, of course, the enemy is going to come in with reinforcements. They only have a Jaeger company there. The line will advance as well. Up to about that point. The howitzers should be clear to fire now. Fire! And off the shots go. Kaboom! It looked a lot more devastating than it was. The enemy only lost two men. Right, open up with the cannons. The light infantry has to advance a bit further before they can return fire on the Jaeger company. Oh, they are within range. It's just that not all companies are within range. Here comes the return fire. Boom! They're not very effective, are they? The howitzers. I mean, the shot landed right there. That guy's standing there like nothing really happened. We're losing a ton of men just by the rifle. They're so good with the... oh, look at that. Not only have we lost a lot of troops in front, this unit marching up, you can see they have lost how many have they lost? Almost 30 men. They've lost 30 men just by sort of fire that that missed the enemy. Howitzers are really crap. Not only are they not really accurate, but clearly they do not kill, or at least on these guys in spread out formation. And sell the Voltigeurs to redraw. Maybe the Howitzers will do better against heavier targets. The enemy is wasting their cavalry up front.
Our men are running, sir!
More Jaegers. Really do despise the Jaegers. The cavalry was quite easily sent off, given how they just threw themselves at our line ahead without any form of support by the by infantry and other units. Let's see if they're gonna come this way. If they do, gonna unleash a volley on them. Ready yourselves, men! Oh, they run. Then fire! I said fire! Damn your eyes. Well, lucky that the enemy did actually run away, because these guys wouldn't have fired at them. Oh, they're coming back. Voltigeurs on this side, the Trilliers of Corsica is firing on well, or were firing on well. The Hussars won't really gain any ground there. Idiots. Let's see if we can gain some ground. The enemy is just sending forwards all their cavalry, and they're getting destroyed. Which will be good, because I will keep my mobility by having my cavalry units intact, while the enemy will waste their potential. Form square, and the Trilliers will fall back towards this location. That Howitzer shot almost hit this square. Halt! And open fire! Fire upon them! Immediately! Fire upon the lances, you morons! Oh, it's because they had that. Maybe I should have let them run. Fire upon them! Fire upon them! Hold your ground, sir! There we go. You could see quite a lot of them fell there, but still there's a lot of lances left in that unit. And there's one lancer unit over here. No, it's Hussars. Form back into line. The enemy general has have plenty of time to set up his men. Well, we'll bash these guys. Yes, they were bashed. And now, it's time for us to advance in the general direction of the enemy. The Voltigeurs will go over there as well. And the cavalry will follow. And I do believe that we're going to have to move the artillery. This cannon piece, we're not going to move that because it's going to take too much time to get that moving. We're just going to move the howitzers because they can be set up quite close and they can fire above the town on to the Austrians, which are forming into lines. But of course, at this point, without their cavalry, which is running away. But look at all the men that's lying over here. Just killed by those Jaegers. Lost so many men due to them. And they stood their ground. There's not that much risk for the Voltigeurs moving up now, since the enemy cavalry has been killed off. The howitzers should be ready to move. I'm not entirely sure what... Let's start them off towards this location. They will move through the forest if I do that. Let's move them there first and then turn. My lines are moving up. Do we have anything special? We have this unit, which is a veteran unit. But in terms of special uniforms, it's only really the Corsican Voltigeurs that have kind of a special uniform. Oh, and Marshal Ney turns up to aid the army. Go on, Voltigeurs, get in line. And let's speed this up a bit. Where are the Voltigeurs? Right, the rest of the army is quite close behind, so we're gonna move you up. And see about attacking the enemy. Cannon's gonna take a while, so I think we'll probably finish the battle without. Let's set up all the cavalry over here for one massive cavalry charge to come through the forest, over the hill, and then sweep down upon them. First, of course, we must find them. See, the cannons have cleared the forested area. Should be able to move towards there now without much difficulty. There's the Austrian army in quite the disarray, so we can move up and fire upon them. This one, I think that's a bit far running. These guys,
sir,
are where we can run.
Sir, our general is under attack.
Shots from that Jaeger company flew all the way there, flew past the general enough so that... Oh, he actually lost a man from his bodyguard due to the Jaegers. Maybe the general should hide behind the church instead. The Voltigeurs are laying down fire. The Austrians start falling. But the Jaeger companies are the more pressing targets. These three units will march towards the hill. These three will march towards here. And the ones in the city we'll try to come somewhere around there. We'll see how that goes. We have Marshal Ney coming up there. The howitzers. How far can they fire? Okay, they can actually fire at the enemy at this point, so You know what? Stop them right here. And then we'll have them open fire upon the enemy. My Voltigeers have lost quite a lot of men. But I'm hoping they're able to inflict some damage upon the enemy Jaegers. The light cavalry is ready. Okay, we're coming quite close here. Form into lines. And I think you probably have to go like that instead. It's a bloody cart in the way. And then you are taking a strange way to get towards the enemy. Get in line over there. And you coming in from the flank. Getting flanked shot. These guys readying themselves. Getting in line, prepared against the German grenadiers. See if we can get you maybe a bit like that. Right, nice. Now they'll be able to return fire. How about you guys come a bit closer? We can send those guys off. These two are holding. We've got Marshal Ney close by. The Voltigeers are holding. These three lines should now quickly move up to start flanking the enemy on that side. By the church, fighting is going well. This unit is stationed very badly and is losing a lot of men. The German grenadiers were pushed back, and there's quite the opportunity to push around the enemy here with these three. So they will be able to come around towards this house and go through like that. And there's a lot of fire coming down here from the flank. We can now move the cavalry onto the hill. And then they will ride down upon the enemy. Quite a lot of fire going back and forth here. The Jaegers was pushed off, which is good. Oh crap, why did you... Oh, I didn't really control that very well, did I? Grenadiers were sent down the wrong alleyway. Set up through here then. These guys were totally destroyed, more or less. Which means that these guys will move up quickly. And these two will come along here. Grenadiers versus Grenadiers. Lining up. But they're losing a lot due to all the fire that's coming down. And they're gonna get flank fired. Let's move quickly and we can bayonet charge them. And send them off. Poorly placed unit here is gonna get shredded. As the chasseur up here will start to lay in them from the flank. Grenadiers, charge them! They have no chance there, really, to stand against our charge. Stop the charge and deploy in between the houses. You two will gain some ground on the enemy. Soon these guys will perish. Did we? No, we haven't set up the guns. I forgot about that. These two will move up. We need to start... oh, what's going on over here? The blasted Jaeger company has turned up again in our flank. Come on, get over there. Let's see if both of you... No, one... One will suffice to... Oh, yes, that's not one of our units. That's an enemy unit. Boom. These guys are defeated. Right, move up through the town. Possibly coming under a flank here. We got Jaeger Company going around. We don't like that. Let's mobilize the cavalry. We're going to have to send them in. Around through here and send those bloody skirmishers away, because otherwise they're just gonna cut our men to shreds. Heavy cavalry will be stationed over here. Light cavalry needs to be down here as quickly as possible, and then we'll strike this area. Gain ground and prepare. You need to soften the enemy target. Oh, they're being charged over here. Austrian grenadiers fighting the voltigeurs. That's not gonna go well for our men.
Our men are running, sir.
They're fleeing, and they've opened up a hole in the center of our line. Which is not good. This unit's about to completely give way. Fall back to that house. But there's a number of units there that could move, gain ground upon the enemy. Heavy cavalry smashed into the enemy. And they will continue. The light cavalry will continue and get the Jaegers. Well, one of them will. The more sizable unit will hit the 20th Hungarian unit. Did my voltigeurs? Yes, they have come back. Move up into this forested area, or in this this shrubbery area. Go on, light cavalry. The emperor was hit. Look at all the men that died right here. Heavy cavalry going in, very nice. They're all done for now. This unit is the last one to give, the 6th Grenadiers. But there they go, and Austria is finally dealt with. Never did I think that I would defeat the Prussians before I defeated the Austrians. But that is how that went. I was hoping to do this battle a little bit quicker, but it took quite some time. But now, the Austrians are done for. Just gonna auto save quickly and auto resolve. Austria is no more. Good replenishment rate, and we've got three armies here ready to strike out. Currently, we're not actually at war with the Ottomans, but we will as soon as possible go to war with them as well. And then we'll make sure that we can fight off the Russians as well. Polish army is not a long way away from being completed. We've got two armies coming up here ready to set up with Napoleon. So we can secure Eastern Prussia. We have a few problems with some of the German states. Saxony is the one that dislikes us the most, and they might declare war on us. I've sent these guys just to secure Berlin, because they're not very happy in Berlin. Then the Danish are also quite unhappy with us. And I'm not entirely sure, maybe I should check so they do not trade with my enemies. But it looks, no, only Sweden trades with England. But otherwise, the German states are on my side. We're going to move this guy, and so on and so forth. Most importantly, though, is my attack on Ireland. Now, the English have quite a lot of full stacks around here. Luckily, though, my navy has been able to move in here, and since they block this area, Wellington can't come across. They still have a full stack, though. And so the general I put in charge of this army, which is Francois Joseph, is going to have to move first on Dublin, take care of that. I'm not entirely sure. What I'll do is, I think, if I can, I'll out-resolve that, and I'll check sort of the benefit of possibly creating the Irish Republic, or just keeping Ireland if I can recruit troops from there. It's sort of similar to what I did to Poland. Because I would want to recruit special units from there. I probably should have done that with some of these German states as well. But we can go ahead and do that in the end, since the whole goal of the campaign is to take over the German states and not really go for the other parts. Anyways, what do I have left to do? I've moved everything. And there's something I forget. But I can't recall what. There's something I think I need to move, or maybe a battle or something. But no, I don't think so. So that means that I've done what I'm supposed to. Yes, the only thing I need to say is about the trade navies. I've been able to secure a slot here for ivory, so we'll make sure that we get these guys over there. Then these guys will join. We've got that ship we captured of the Swedes. We'll go there as well. So we'll make loads of money off trade. I'm recruiting tons of troops that will be sent over to the Russian front, because we're going to need a lot to defeat the Russians. Trying to avoid invading Sweden, and I think we will be able to avoid that, because it's going to take a lot of resources and not really a gain, and the Swedes only have the navy, so I can have my navy deal with them. Anyways, let's go ahead and end turn and see what the enemy comes up with. The Russians are at war with us again. As you can see, the border has turned red, and the fact that this guy went across, probably a reaction to my conquest of the Austrians. So now they are gone. I do, however, get to see what's going on there, because I secured a trade agreement with the Russians. Okay, so this what I think I'll do is, the first opportunity I will use the Polish army to defeat some Russian army. So we'll get an army entirely comprised of Polish units, which I think is quite interesting, and we'll be able to use them on our enemies. The Russians have a lot of troops. It would be kind of nice if I somewhere could like see some statistics or something, like how many men does Russia currently have, because with all their full stacks, how many men do I even have? Because I must have quite a lot as well. I have I have 3 full stacks in the last Austrian territory. I've got 3 full stacks going towards Königsberg. I've got the one in Poland. So that makes 7. And then I have the one that's... Just go ahead and stuff yourself, kebab man. I have no interest in... He comes with demands, even though he's only... His only European control is that one area. Hopefully the Romanians will deal with them at some point. Or if they've start... I've given the Romanians so much money that... I mean, I hope... that they... are planning some kind of attack. So Russia joins my enemies again. They have a full stack in the capital. They have a small stack here, and they've got one guy guarding the bridge. They have a factory. They have all the nice stuff here. Great Museum and Army College. Great Estate. Maybe I should give them some more land, but I'm not entirely sure. Let's go ahead and see then. Let's go ahead and see. Right. Attack Dublin, Ireland. So what I'll do is I'll continue the siege, and I'll check which is the best option, and then for the next episode we'll see what has happened with that, and then yes, what we'll do for this one is we'll move few units that need moving. I'm probably making tons of money off that, of all the ivory. Maybe I should move more ships over there. Let's see, trade ivory. They're 52 compared with everything else, like sugar is 40. That's quite high. 38 for cotton. 40 for sugar, that's quite good. Spice, not so good, actually. What are we getting here? Oh, sugar. Where are we getting the spice from? The spice is getting from down here, and we got quite a lot of ships over here. Coffee, what's the price of coffee? Coffee is 23, what spice is... Well, what I can do is I can send... What we'll do is we'll keep some of the ships here. We'll move all of these. And these will join the ivory trade. And so we'll concentrate on ivory and get as much of that as possible. Because we're going to make so much money from that. These guys will go ahead and join our naval force up there. Only one turn away until we can build some really large ships, I hope. One turn until the Arc de Triomphe. And that should enable some new cavalry, I think. We've got troops moving around. We're at war with the Russians again. We'll need to station our armies accordingly. We can have Lan stationed over there, moving that way. And these two guys, Ney, will be on the road towards here. We've got four full stacks ready to fight them. God, that's a lot. The spies moving into their positions. And then... Polish army, they'll be ready in 2 turns, but I think I might move them out anyways, so next turn we can fight this army with the Polish. Then we've got Napoleon, and Napoleon is about to be reinforced by Nicholas Udino, and Saul. Very good. These Germans are getting into Berlin. Very nice. So, anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this, and hopefully I'll see you guys for the next one. Bye!